Morning. Morning.
Good morning.
Can you state your name more, please?
My name's Ben. I'm the director for this production of Loop.
I'm Toby Hall, and I was the producer for the short film Loop.
My name is Will Collard, and I'm the director of photography and writer for the short film Loop.
My name is Simeon Gooderham, and I was the chief editor and also the BTS videographer.
My name's Jamie, and I was the camera operator for film Loop.
My name's Kyle, and I was the sound designer in the FMP.
Director, how's it going so far? A-okay.
Hey, is that surprisingly going okay? Mainly because he was on time.
He was on time. Have fun, guys. We'll see you at a location. Definitely heard that.
Cinematic
producer, how's it going?
Well, it's going all right. We're on time.
So what's the plan for the first shot?
So this first shot, the talent is going to be lying down in bed. And we're going to have a phone here on the bedside table, and the alarm's going to go off.
Mm-hmm.
And we need it to be dark in here, like it's the morning, and because the phone screen is going
to
be the only light. So we've done a bit of a
bit of DIY.
Bro, that look.
Tape on some phones, and we're going to get someone to
hold that.
I don't know, give it really, but
hold that up. Look.
So how's it going, Kyle?
Yeah, not too bad.
Not too bad. What's happened?
I've got to set this up. Hopefully get this strap round, so obviously cables and hazards or anyone falling over.
Yeah, that's true.
That would be awful. But yeah, I'm trying to think of how.
How do you connect it? Yeah.
Can
you set it safe, maybe?
Yeah, possibly. But I've set it around my waist.
That's true. It might be a bit low. I haven't been changing in a while.
Yeah, it's alright.
Okay.
Yeah,
you're good. Don't mind me, just do your thing.
I go off in about a minute, by the looks of it.
Yeah.
Two shot one.
Any minute now. And cut. Oh, that was brilliant.
You can see some hard manual labour.
It was heavy. Ooh, hoorah!
It doesn't weigh anything.
Also, Simeon, what's wrong with your light?
Simeon, can you grab the battery for the light?
Sorry, I'm just going to.
Thank you. As well, there, guys.
Yeah?
Oh, well, just put, like, look in there. Find something if you want.
Stab it in there. There's a Rubik's Cube. There's some
ornaments in it.
Do you want to say that to the camera, Carl?
What? Okay, Jesus Christ, just light up the entire.
I'm gonna become blind, mate, after this shoot.
So we're now on our lunch break. How's it going, Will?
It's nice, yeah. Oh, how's the shoot going?
Yeah.
Yeah, shoot's gone well.
She's going well, yeah?
Yep.
Schedule.
Why are we ahead of schedule, Toby?
Because I'm eating a feta cheese slow roasted tomato pasta.
That is the only reason we're ahead of schedule.
Yeah.
Come on, Clarissa Ripta, who's today? What's happening?
I'm going to Sainsbury's to get a drink.
To get a drink?
Yeah. Would you like to come?
No, I won't come, but can you get me a... Surprise me. Give me some. I don't know. I'll pay for you back then.
Yeah, that's fine. I'll do that.
Have fun.
No. Oh, mate.
You're going to stop
blinding that. Blinded!
How far is that, mine?
Huh?
That's
not yours. Yeah. Will. All the footage is just me, us like.
Just like.
One, action!
What was that noise?
I'm saying that, but it's not that bright.
It's really bright,
Simeon.
It's really not.
It really is.
And a what? Of off in
there? Oh, she said left.
Some cool cinematic shots.
Oh, on your story. Action!
We haven't got one.
3, 2, 1, action.
Yeah, I think it went quite well. The whole crew was really motivated at the start, and we made sure that we had all the gear, we had the gear list, and we were making sure that we were doing it properly.
I think day one was okay. It was our first day of the production, like shooting, obviously. And I think for a first day as a team, like we were all getting to know how each other like properly worked on a set.
We were at Carl's house filming with Grace. In this tiny room with a lot of us in there, which didn't work at all, and it was a good day overall.
Day one was I think it was a decent start. We got a couple of scenes done. There wasn't any difficulties or any barriers in the way. But no, I think it went quite good.
Ended up not using any of the footage in the final cut, which obviously looking back on it now is frustrating because we put the time and effort in. But, you know, for the quality of the film, we've had to cut it all.
I feel like everyone was more motivated and we just tried to do everything properly, but it went a bit slow looking back at it. If we'd worked faster like we did on other days, I think it would have, yeah.
I mean, it helped a lot having actual, like, proper lighting, proper kit with us, instead of just shooting on just a camera and a lens. Made my life a lot easier, especially with the monitor, for example, because I could see every colour that I needed to, graphs, focus peaking, stuff like that, which helped a lot, definitely.
It ran quite smooth, definitely. For a first day of production, it was good.
Overall, yeah, day one, good day.
What's happening?
Find anything. What's happening? It's day two.
Day two?
Day two. Day two, we're going to shoot at Carl's again.
Hello!
The current time is 9:05.
There's one. Oh, no! And those!
If you get two of the screens, do you?
Yeah.
Hello. You alright?
Oh,
what time do you call this?
Thank you.
What time do I call this?
9:10.
Even hours before you.
Hey? Even hours before you, and I was late.
Toby's on the loo.
Hi guys, welcome back to the video!
Right, let's go.
Right, yeah, let's go.
So basically, this is a chicken.
Is there just one chicken?
I don't know, it's not mine.
I think there's only one chicken.
Good morning. Hello.
Bum.
Bum.
Let's go look at our set. Wow! We are going to have to do some clearing. Look at that. Got a big boy monitor there. Let's go out and take a look at our sound operator.
Got one of the X.
I've got to get 5 pence piece.
5 pence. Do you mind?
Got to find the match.
Yeah.
And play a bit of Fortnite, Battle Royale.
Yeah, that's right, guys. I'm a pro.
A pro, yeah?
Yep. Ah! Fourth place!
Oh, no. Kyle made me lose.
Oh my god,
fourth place. Fourth place, and Kyle made me lose.
See you!
Alright,
I'm gonna get fourth place then. Alright,
I'm gonna make it for me. Good morning.
Simeon's bought sweets.
Sweets. Sweets.
Sweets.
Sweets.
Sweet.
Loop it out.
We are so productive.
Action. Hello.
Stop playing.
We are setting up for scene 7, shot 1. It's got the tape machine over there. So Hannah Smith in the film, she's going to be walking up. And she's going to be putting in the tape.
We need to get behind you.
Okay. And basically, this scene is basically just to establish the tape machine. As the tape machine is a big part of the of this.
How are things going, Toby?
Doing alright.
Doing alright? What's happening at the moment?
Yeah, we're doing scene 7.
Scene 7.
Set up for shot 2.
Shot 2, yeah.
Yeah. Pretty good. I'm putting a battery on charge because the light died.
Anything going wrong?
No.
Apart from we can't do the match shot.
Oh yeah,
I'm sure that I can't do the match shot.
Yeah.
Because we haven't got the right costume. Scene 7, take 2, shot 2. Oh, no, no, no. Guys, we can hear through the microphone.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, you can hear
through
the microphone.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool, isn't it?
That's insane.
It's pretty insane. Got a little speck on it. Yeah.
How's it going, well?
It's good, man.
Going well, yeah. So what's happening? Don't say it's bright, it's not bright.
Should
we just ignore
it? So, this is scene 7, shot 4.
Scene 7, take 1, shot 4.
Right, and action! Right, now turn. Jamie, full focus. Cut there. Action. Turn. And cut there.
Scene 7, take 1, shot 7.
Action.
Hello. It's going good. Bit slow today. The one day we actually need to hurry up. That'll be 3 scenes down, if I'm correct. 4 scenes down.
We've got to reshoot the one shot.
Okay, we've got to reshoot some things.
Just rehearse that for me, please, one time.
But it's looking...
Looking up.
Very good.
I'm going. Simeon, what are you doing still here?
I think about like
300-500 pounds. Yeah. We missed anything, did we? We did everything on the
We need to redo the match cut shot.
But everything's technically over on the schedule.
Everything is.
Let's just reshoot.
Tomorrow, yeah, tomorrow morning.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Bye.
Well, so, Toby, what have you found?
So I found some tissue. And a banana. The banana's very brown.
Oh dear.
I don't know why the banana's brown. Where has been put
that? Whose desk is this, Toby?
This is Kyle Lane's desk.
It's Kyle's Lane. It's Kyle's Lane's desk.
Ew. I need to wash my hands.
Yeah, I would too.
Ew.
Yeah.
Day 2, scenes 6 and 7.
Mm-hmm.
How did that
Very similar to day one, really. We were all like at the start of the production really eager and like into actually trying to get it all done. Again, no major problems really.
Scene 6 and 7. I don't think we actually ended up using scene 6 in the final edit, but scene 7 we did. I'm quite happy with scene 7. I like the way we filmed the book, panning over to it to build the tension in the scene, while also like trying to show what's happening, while trying to tell the story at the same time.
Got sewing machine, We got sewing machines. Oh my god. We got some scenes shot, got quite a few actually on day two, which was overall good.
But yeah, I think day two was very similar to day one, in the fact of like progress and workflow.
We had a few struggles with that day because we had to get our talent sat on the desk, and then we had the bed as well, and to set up the tripod with the camera so close to the talent was quite hard.
Yeah, day two was fine, all went good.
This is a shambles.
It's not.
Maybe we should actually go and talk to Jake.
Yeah, that's fine.
This is an absolute shambles.
No, we've gone to try and find a trolley to move equipment.
I guarantee it's 8,
but we can't.
No, that hasn't gone very well.
We can't find the trolley.
This is a record of
proof of innocence right now.
We couldn't find it. It's still there. No one wants it. We couldn't find the one we printed out, so we're just taking this one.
How are things going, Will?
Apart from the fact that we spent an hour trying to find a trolley.
Yeah, it's a bit of an issue.
Apart from that, it's fine. And today we're shooting the
bus scene.
Stop and Costa. It's going to be stress.
We might as well just bring the bag.
Sure, is that all our stuff then?
Everything's in the bag.
Simeon,
are we in the bag?
Just bring the bag.
What
are you about to do?
So basically I'm going to record the talent,
record the talent.
I'm going to call them because they're late.
Okay. Yeah, I didn't really know what time, but yeah.
What? Are you free now? Hello?
Where should I meet you guys?
Hello? In the front of the media block.
Alright, coming now.
Okay, thank you.
Bye.
Oh yes.
I've never heard a song before.
What are we doing then?
So we're going to the bus stop now.
Mm-hmm. You know?
Getting the bus stop scene. It's a bit cozy back here, but you know. When he's on TikTok, he is a proper gun, isn't he?
Just not leave valuables in your car. I didn't see any parking, so I'm assuming.
Do not leave valuables in the car.
Okay. I've been sat on that bench for 40 fucking minutes.
That's your fault.
Oh, no!
Oh no, the dead cat!
The dead cat!
Can you put it back on?
Got a dead cat on my finger.
So
on the map.
Quite fine, the levels were turned down.
Toby, how's it going?
It's going alright. We've had some slight issues, but we are resolving them.
Resolving them, that's good, yeah. What's happening at the moment?
They're setting up for a shot, so when the bus comes past, we're going to get an empty shot of just the bus driving past. And then the talent is going to stand in place, and then in post, we're going to
merge them together. How's it going, Ben?
It's going good. I'm already tired because I've walked.
Hi guys! Welcome back! Who's to say? What's impossible will be for them? Wow! We'll sing and dance to Mother Nature's song.
And rise up, hey! Destiny is calling me. Open up my eager eyes. Cause I've missed the bright side. Risk assessment.
Yeah.
Okay. Cold drinks do they do?
That's gonna be too cold, aren't
they? Yeah, probably. Right.
Guys, we're sponsored by Costa. Yo.
Hey, Kyle.
So what are we doing here, director man?
Setting up.
Setting up for what?
It's been helpful. We're setting up for the camera shot. The camera shot? The Costa shot. As you can see, we're in Costa.
Look at all this stuff.
Right, so Toby.
Yep.
Just filmed the Costa scene.
We did.
Scene 8. How'd it go?
Well, we only had an hour to work with. We got there around 2:15 and started putting lights on tripods at 2:30. And then we could properly start moving our set and crafting our set towards 3:00.
Yeah.
Because people were starting to leave. And then we had an hour to film. It was a tight time frame to get everything done in. We kind of rushed all of the last handheld shots, but we got them.
Yeah, it was just more of a matter of fact of time was definitely against us.
Yes.
Just little issues, but I think we got it in the end.
I think we got it, so...
Reunited!
So, Alan, are we your best students?
Was that a yes? I think that was a yes.
I think I heard a yes.
We've just finished the shooting of Costa. We've backed up the footage. Where are we going now?
We're going to Flip Out.
Ooh.
It's a trampoline park.
Whee!
Right, Will?
Yeah,
I'm good. Right. Hi, guys.
Simeon, how was your Mackies?
I never Simeon, really.
It's get a bit of video.
Look, we're at Flip Out.
Flip Out.
Way.
Flip Out.
So, Simeon, how was Flip Out?
Flip Out was great. It was so good. I really enjoyed it.
I can't see you at all.
You can't see me?
No.
You can see me now.
I think you can't see me.
Oh dear. Bad day. Worst day. So it was a Friday. We got all the stuff that we shot on day 3, we did not use.
Yes. So not the whole crew was here for this day. Ben, the director, was waiting at the location already for the bus stop scene. And then we had Will, Simeon, who was driving,
the actor and myself. Unfortunately, our camera operator, Jamie, couldn't be there, and Kyle wasn't able to make it for the morning, but he was there for the Costa scene in the end. We ended up not using any of the shoots, any of the footage from day three, because we had some issues with like camera settings when we got back. The white balance was off and just little stuff like that. I think the shoot, as like we got, because we looked at the bus times and everything was, we planned everything out and got everything that we needed for that, but it just didn't work out. We needed to reshoot and we didn't have time, so.
Wasn't a fun day. Probably, I'd say the worst day of the production as a whole. Yeah, we went out to the bus stop in the morning, cut that completely, just didn't really work, didn't fit at all. And then headed to Costa, trying to film all of Costa within an hour to set up, film, make sure we had everything was not good.
For that day, I actually had to rent out or buy insurance for my dad's car because I couldn't actually afford, we couldn't actually fit that many people in the car. So I had to get insurance on my dad's car to fit everyone in. But that was it was a right day. It started off better, I think, than it finished. But from the beginning of the day, we had to go to the bus stop where Ben was already waiting for us, while also trying to film as much as we can while waiting for the bus to come without getting distracted by everything else happening around us. It took quite a while to do that. But when later on in the day, we all got back to the college, set up everything for Costa. We only had an hour to shoot that though. And it was very, very stressful to film everything in that time. I mean, the DOP was very stressed about getting everything in time. But again, I was trying to do the BTS for that, making sure we had everything for our websites and also for the actual interviews as well for behind the scenes.
For what we did, it was very rushed, and I feel like if we included that in for our final, it would not look great.
Do you think the film would have been better with these scenes in?
After looking at it with and without, I think it looks good without it in, because obviously we didn't do that good of a job of it.
Brilliant, yeah, that's fine. It's just, I need to know that I'm going to put as sheets.
And we might not have everything on there.
Hi.
Say that.
Boom!
Do we have a boom on?
No.
Day for shoot four. I don't know what day it is, but it's a day. We weren't meant to be shooting at the wind down, but weather's not the best.
Where are we today then?
We are at Kyle's house at Summerway Cottage. Doing scene 10, the lighter sequence.
Yep, my back really hurts.
What's happening now? It's not going well. Kyle, our sound guy, I think he's still asleep.
We can't get in. So, great start to the day.
So, Kyle's mum, Mrs. Lane, if you're watching this, please open the door for us, please. Because it's getting chilly out. It's not actually that cold. So.
Open now.
Whoa, we're in Kyle's house.
You see what the boys are doing? They're in here.
Hmm? Oh. Hello.
My brother needs a nerf gun. I've got a whole back of nerf.
That's right.
Find the nerf gun. I don't know whether it's a little nerf gun. I don't know where it's gone. I'm just gonna spin off the target. I don't know where it is, but just conscious shit, right?
Yo, what?
Yeah, don't
think else. Mate, that is
sick. It comes out as well.
No way.
Yeah, just don't say it.
Enjoying yourself there, mate?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
That's mad.
Can I light the book?
No.
Should I set the book on fire?
They're gonna play football. That's a tree. Oh.
That's some cinematic shots.
Oh.
He's a lot more comfortable.
Oh,
it's a proper zipper, that's why it's good.
What are we actually doing now, Toby?
So basically,
We shouldn't have liked it. Lighter sequence.
Yeah.
Are we waiting for you?
No, I'm watching.
I don't like the shadow.
It's like, yeah, you can see the shadows.
Can we try putting it?
You can turn that down a little bit more, to be fair.
Scene 10, shot whatever, take 3.
Fire.
Right, and 3, 2, 1, action. Look around. Okay, scene 10, shot whatever, take 2.
Hang on.
Turn off.
No, because she's doing
it. Oh, never mind.
Yeah. Right.
And action.
It's gonna be a fucking thing.
Oh, so die!
Come on,
you closer, come closer, come closer.
Where are we going?
Right.
Grab your van!
Oh, is the thing working?
I think it's on Simeon.
The battery just died.
Well, man, blue hand.
Blue. Ooh. It's grey.
Oh, yeah.
That day went well. I was the hand actor in that, so I had to get makeup done on me. I think Steph did a very good job of doing the makeup. It looked very good, but that went very well. I had to stand behind Grace, the actor, whilst they lifted my hand over to try and create like a build the tension in the scene, whilst also trying to capture like the viewer in the scene as well. So I didn't have much time to do BTS. I had to hand that off to other people, but again, I had no other choice. I had to do the hand for that.
So day 4, yeah, we had Grace, and we also had the makeup artist come in to do Simeon's hand, who's our editor. Got his whole arm painted to look some skeletal figure almost that we had to use to clap the light for the light sequence off, so it went completely pitch black. And that overall day 4 went pretty well. We got a lot done, surprisingly. We got some reshoots done, I think, as well, on day 4, which we didn't use in the end. And we stayed at Carl's house for that one.
But this was not a good day. We got what we needed to, but a lot of the crew were, we were really tired and unmotivated and really needed to, no one was kind of cracking on with the job.
It went okay, I think. We only had like an hour and a half, 2 hours to shoot on that day. And I think, yeah, what we could have done with the lighter, we did as much as we could have done. I think could have done more with the hand coming out of the darkness, like clapping out the flame. But I think it went pretty well for what it was.
Light and scene is obviously very key in our F&P in the shot. So with that, we had a lot of light in, obviously, the room we're still using. We had a lot of light coming through. So obviously that was a difficulty we had to get rid of because it would have just looked awful in it. So what we did is we got a blanket and we put it up in the window. We taped it up, obviously blocked the light, so the light zoom was worked perfectly. But no, it was great. The light sequence, that's what we focused on that day, and it looked great.
again, from a DOP standpoint, I'm not particularly that happy with a few of the shots in that light sequence, especially the shot where like she opens up the flame. Because of the dynamics of the room, we couldn't like pull far back enough, even on 24 millimeters. We were still pretty tight, close to Grace with the lighter.
Shooting in that low light environment was quite challenging because obviously, you know, trying to shoot as low an ISO as possible while still trying to catch the lighter in. I mean, it was a shame a bit because I was crushing the shadows. I mean, you can't see that much in the production, but I could tell. But yeah, I mean, went all right. It turned out, probably could have turned out better. I think if we'd had a bit more lighting and whatnot, you know, it could have definitely made it a better scene and helped those shadows a bit. But yeah, I think all in all, that day turned out all right.
Didn't forget the BTS, don't worry. There he is. He's leaving now.
Hey, he's got a bald. Haircut.
Called it.
Yeah, this is late, by the way.
What time do you call this?
You want BTS?
Yeah, flag problem.
No, it's just going to have to go through. Or I can go in the back.
I look like a 30-year-old man, I hate it, alright?
No, you can't, in prison.
There's a rabbit!
There's a rabbit. Where's he gone? It's over there.
There's a rabbit! There's two rabbits! Oh! There's loads of rabbits! There was like five rabbits!
Okay, so Ben, we've got a lot to do today, so we're gonna say goodbye to BTS.
Yeah, not much BTS going on today.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Goodbye, we'll see you later.
Bye, BTS.
Actually, they can sit without all their lights.
Yeah. Scene turn, take one, roll 12.
So that, again, we were at Carl's house. I think that was one of our last days at Carl's. And that was a day where we got most of the shots done. It was our last day. It was the last day we could film at Carl's house, and we had to get everything done. So we just knuckled down. There isn't much behind the scenes for that day because we did just knuckle down. We got everything done as we possibly could. We got the tape scenes done. We got all the scenes of the bedroom done. And it was a good day overall. We're all happy with it. And we used most of the shots in the film. It was actually used on day 5.
We had to knuckle down and work really hard to get everything done because we couldn't use the room after this day. And we still had quite a lot to shoot, which was the tape sequence and the loop sequence. Loop sequence, we did some tests. It was quite difficult to get our heads around. Even though we had done the tests already, it was still difficult to get ahead of and on the actual location. The tape sequence, I think, turned out pretty well. And the slide, we were slightly worried about the slider because it was a manual slider, it wasn't electronic, because we couldn't get our hands on an electronic one. I think we actually did a good job and managed to, and it worked, turned out really good. And yeah, so that was a productive day, but a tiring one.
I think this was definitely the best day, because coming into it, we knew that we had to, like, work. We knew we had to go quick, because we only had that day remaining to shoot, like, two sequences of scene 10, which takes up the majority of the film. We had to work quick. We used a slider on this day, which I think was really good to put in, like sliding in on the tape and on Grace. Yeah, getting the loop sequence, it was quite tricky for ourselves to like wrap our heads around and actually like understand what shots we needed to get for the loop to make sense.
So yeah, the tape sequence, we wanted to make sure that was a lot of tension building in that. So we made sure to film, we filmed everything, or that part anyway, with a slider. We wanted to try and get an automatic slider, but we ended up not choosing it because we found it was cheaper and also kind of easier just to do it manually, so we can just fix it in post with a bit of warp stabilization. We also zoomed in or slided into Grace's POV as well, from her looking at the tape machine. I think those two shots worked very well, interchanging with one another in the edit, and I'm really happy that it went that way. But going to loop sequence, this is one thing that was very like iffy filming. We weren't exactly sure how it was gonna turn out. We did do a test before, but that, it was all right. We had no lighting for the test. It was more just trying to see how to visualize it and how to actually do it. So as we went through it, started filming it, we went through all the parts, trying to get as much footage as we can to try and make sure it made sense. So it actually looked like she was looping, because that is the name of the film. We needed to make sure this part was actually worked and it was actually viewable and made sense.
Day five was all right. This is when we did knuckle down quite a lot to get it all done, because we knew we were on a tight schedule. We need to get it done, or we're going to be stupidly behind. So the loop bit is actually one of my favourite parts. I do like it. It's very original. It just works, I do think. I think it's probably one of the best out of all of it.
I think with the tape deck scene and whatnot, it was luckily quite easy to film because we had good lighting in that scene. I mean, you know, it was quite a scene to shoot.
Everyone, don't die!
I feel like a hiker. You're jealous.
Going for a hike, boys!
Go, Jamie.
Why?
Go for a little hike.
Yeah, love it.
Out in the wilderness.
God. We've been stranded. It's been a week now. We're stranded. I think we're gonna die. If you find this, I'm dead.
So, Will, we're here.
Yes.
Tripods and stuff and give them stuff first.
Well, leave them lying, bro.
Are you fucking throwing them all over the place? Oh, man.
I want it that way.
Right?
Yeah. It's going to be well.
Cool.
Oh, I'm bad. I'm fighting my rock.
This kid.
Hello, man. I didn't know this. It's terrible.
if you sort of just point. Go for the neck kind of thing.
Go for the neck.
Yeah. So,
try it. Just
kill right, pretty agonizing for you there.
And then go for it.
Make sure the hand comes hold, all the way down.
Hold it.
Yeah.
I want to feel sound guy as well.
Sound guy.
Sound guy.
Sound guy.
Look at sound guy.
Gavin. Stop. Stop. Ben, stop.
Ben, it's the truth.
Back of it. Ben, back.
Ben.
There. Ben, where you are, you're not in shot. So you can just stand there. The tree covers you.
Ow!
What the fuck just happened?
Oh no.
Yeah, scene 12, take 1, shot 4. 3, 2, 1, and action.
This book costs 20p.
And cut there.
Hello.
Hello.
Don't know what day shoot this is.
Shoot 6.
Shit.
How's it going, Ben?
Day 6.
Not too close. It's
really... Day 6.
Watch me run.
Done.
Ben. Done.
6 was wind down, which was scene 1 and 11.
It wasn't the best experience. It was quite cold, and I feel like we kind of wanted to get out. We didn't have much time, but we were trying to plan. I think we could have done more location scouting and location recce, like at the woods, to find out exactly what we were going to do and where we were going to do it. We had a vague idea, but we spent a lot of time figuring out where to put our talent and the camera. But it wasn't the nicest experience, so we kind of just wanted to finish the day and get home. But I think we got what we needed.
It was like an experience in a production, everyone going off site, setting up in the middle of the woods. It was good. We got quite a lot done on that day with the like trail of pages, getting a lot of like cinematic B-roll of just like the trees and like stuff out there. I think it went well. We've cut quite a bit from that scene, even though it's like the ending. There's still quite a lot in the final cut, but we have got rid of a lot of her like walking around the forest. But I think it worked really well, especially with the like edit in the final cut. I think it's worked really well.
Mainly the problem we had was, I think it was time. Was it time was a problem? But overall, it was actually quite, it was a long trek up there, but it was worth it because it looked really good. We got an old book that we had, and we basically teared it up and everything. And we scattered the paper all on the floor, and we got her to walk on it. And she was quite willingly just walking barefooted pretty much everywhere, which was quite nice of her. So, but overall, good day.
Wind down was good. It went very smoothly, actually. All of the stuff we got, not very much BTS on it. But we only had one of our actors, Grace, which was good. We got Simeon as well, our editor. We had the makeup, do like a, I don't know what we did, like a, I don't know what we called it. It's more like a creature, I don't know. Yeah, it was a creature, yeah. I'll say creature. Well, the makeup we had, did like a, for our editor Simeon, like a creature kind of hand, which looked really good when we did that. That wasn't very long. Got some good, like really wide shots of Grace, which was really good from Will. Windown was really good, actually.
No, I found a few complications with shooting at Windown, especially that's when we first sort of mainly started using the shoulder mount, and that was the first time we used the gimbal as well for the production. And I was trying to fit the monitor to the gimbal, but it wasn't, didn't work out very well. And I mean, you can use it without the monitor, but it was quite hard for me to pull focus and everything while on gimbal. And I just got fed up with the gimbal. And then obviously I switched to the shoulder mount to follow the talent in some ways. And I mean, I built the shoulder rig from scratch using a couple of other ones and put a follow focus on it, but it didn't work the best. I mean, I think just using like I did on the other bits of the production, just a camera strap and just pulling focus handheld, try and shoot that. I mean, I think that worked better.
Day 8 or day 7?
7.
Day
21.
21.
21. What's the problem?
Jamie's late. Camera operator is late.
Is that the storyboard?
Yeah, storyboard.
Is that the storyboard?
Storyboard.
And I'm a clam.
What time did you do this?
Thank you.
The car park near Seven Sisters I can see is 139 miles away.
Hang on. Oh, don't breathe on the lens, oh, bro. Bad. Right. No, Toby.
We're at the Seven Sisters.
Festival?
Profession.
Just on that little slope up there, I see, yeah?
Yeah.
Alright, what are we getting now? What have you just got?
Just got some B-roll.
Nice,
of
nice.
The hills.
Landscape.
What's the problem, Toby?
The wind? No, there's no problem because the wind is going that way.
And that is a pretty big rain cloud there, coming right for us.
It's blowing it that way.
If it starts raining, I'm going to cry laughter. Yeah, wind, I'll laugh, mate, I'll start laughing.
Wind changes direction all the time, though.
Yeah, I know, but.
I'm raining.
Ooh. It's not good. Nature.
Look, Will, that's disgusting.
Now, I want to see if his course has actually went up to like 70 quid.
Bing bong.
Got my little vlog. We're here. Bit stressful. Yeah, I have 40 minutes to do everything.
Is this water? We go behind the rocks, it's no wind sound.
It's very nice.
Right, hang on, let me just see if I've got
right, Toby, we've just finished up here. How do you think it went?
Yeah, I don't really know. I don't even know if anyone knows what we've just got.
Well, overall it went pretty well. We got what we needed, which was the main thing. Like on the last day of the production, we all just wanted to kind of wrap it up, get everything we needed to, and then get it done. Yeah, we got all we needed to. Sound was tricky out there because of the wind and stuff. And we did have like members of the public kind of interfering, getting in the back of shots and a few times asking us what we were doing. But from my point of view, I liked that it was really open. I had a lot of space to like get certain shots. I particularly like the shot where the like title appears in the opening. It went well. I don't think there were many major problems. We have had to cut Allura from that scene, unfortunately, and along with the Costa scene, as we didn't have the Costa scene later in the film, it just didn't make sense to have her character there in the opening, because then she'd just walk off and then never be seen again. It was just like, you know, we had to cut her really for story reasons. yeah, day seven was fine.
The shoot day was meant to be earlier. It was meant to be the last Thursday before we broke up from the college. And it was literally the week after all of the other shoots that we did. But 6 o'clock in the morning, our actor got tonsillitis. She didn't get tonsillitis at 6 o'clock in the morning. she told us. So she wouldn't be able to do it, which was annoying, but she can't help that. And then we rescheduled for after Easter, so it had already been 2 weeks of a break. And when we got back, I feel like we were really unmotivated because of that long break, and struggled to get the team and crew motivated and to do it right. And we couldn't even do it the week back. We had to wait till the week after, because she also had a COVID jab vaccination in the middle of the day, so we couldn't really work around that.
So final day at Seven Sisters, we had a few problems. Obviously getting all the equipment up onto the hill, because it was a good about 25 minute walk with a lot of gear. Hot day, we had no water. It didn't go well to beginning with. We had some problems with the sound. We had some problems with the public, because it was a public area. And obviously we couldn't have people had keep coming into shot. We didn't have that much time anyway. We had about maybe an hour or so before our talent had to leave. We had both talents there. And it was an interesting day, to say the least. We got the shots we wanted.
So Will and Toby got a... It's the...
landscape.
Yeah, that's it, landscape. Well, view of it. And then me and Jamie set up by the bench, ready for Grace. We did include Laura as well. Obviously, by the final take, we didn't include her. We didn't think it flowed with the storyline, and we obviously sent him out about that, which was fine. But no, and then obviously the crew later came, and then we did recording with her. It's great. Sound wasn't the best though for that day. I recorded a lot of outside tones, footsteps and that, to see if we could use it. But the wind was awful. We also had a lot of flies in our shot as well. That wasn't the greatest, but we couldn't help that. But no, Seven Sisters was quite good.
But yeah, when we did film that, again, we had to take the actors up to the top of the hill. It was like a 20-minute walk from where the parking space was, which is very annoying and it's very tiring, but it's what we had to do for the shot. And I think the final product was actually very good. Putting a lot of work to actually get there was definitely worth it, I think, in my opinion. Because there's a lot of cooler sort of scenes and landscapes that was viewable by there. But I couldn't do much BTS for that because it was like all hands on deck. We only had like 40, 50 minutes to film the whole thing. So there's not much BTS for that, as you can probably tell from what's happening on screen. But yeah, there's not much I could have done BTS-wise for that, because I just had to help with the crew with everything.
F&P as a whole, how do you think it went?
I think it went good. Well, I think overall it's been good. It's had its problems. I think we tried to do too much in such a short amount of space and time. We should have gone for something a lot smaller, shorter, and gone for like proper polished quality. I mean, it's good, our final like cut, but if we tried to do less, the quality would be a lot better, I think. But then that's something we can learn for next year, for any production we ever go on to do. We know to like narrow it down, go smaller and focus even more.
Overall, a lot of things could be improved. But with the amount of time we had, we did okay. Obviously, time was our biggest problem that we had, because we had such little time to get actors. We had such little time to actually film with them. As you know, we only had about 7-8 days to actually film. And even then, we only got about half the day and half of them. And then again, prepping and pre-production is, we need more of that so we can actually prep all of it and get it all done.
You started off, we started off so committed to the whole thing. I think some of us kind of lost interest as we went along, just because they weren't 100% sure it was going to turn out good. And to be fair, I had doubts as well when I was doing it. But obviously, I was the main editor, so I had to make sure I focused the whole time and did everything. And while also like making sure I got enough BTS as well at the same time. So as we were going through all these days, I was editing stuff at home at college, trying to see what scenes worked, but also writing down stuff we had to reshoot, because I thought that would be really important. We want to make sure we get all the scenes we need. So yeah, that went very well. But yeah, everything just went well in general, but like the bad things that did happen kind of ruined a lot of things, but it was fine. And then it ended up, the final product is good. I like the final product.
Overall, I absolutely loved it. I did really enjoy it. For what it was, for me taking my role as sound, I did really kind of enjoy doing it with the group as well. I would give it possibly, if I give it out of 10, I'll give it a 7.5, pushing to an 8. I think that's quite positive score. Yeah.
Do you want to give your final little speech?
I've been Simeon Gooderham. I've been the editor. I am Simeon Gooderham. I was the editor and BTS videographer for our film Looper.
I'm Kyle and I've been the sound designer in the FMP.
So, I'm Jamie and I was the camera operator for Loop.
I'm Will Collard and I've been the director of photography and the writer of Loop.
I'm Toby Hall and I've been the producer for the short film Loop.
So I've been Ben Cox, I'm the director of Loop, and thank you guys for watching.